We witnessed an upward spiraling of violence to next higher levels, amidst which peacekeepers were directly targeted by the extremists. During the crisis, when 45 Fijian peacekeepers were detained by armed members of the opposition, the ordeal that lasted for 15 days, the radicals had made their intent clear and had surrounded another 72 peacekeepers from the Philippines. The Filipino and Fijian peacekeepers bravely faced the situation and exhibited raw courage, resilience, and patience. However, during the release of the peacekeepers, the radical groups reiterated that if presented with another opportunity, they would detain additional peacekeepers, snatch UN vehicles and weapons, and ransack UN property. They have also clearly spelled out that the UN was not required in the area. Last year, we saw four troop contributing countries pulling out of the mission, leaving the mission seriously stretched. It was only Philippines and India who stayed the course, their soldiers taking on significant extra responsibilities during this period. With the help of the Security Council and the troop contributing countries present today in the mission, we were able to transform and empower the mission with additional 200 soldiers, a mechanized company, a counter-IED capability, and we were also able to induct some heavier weapons.